What's going on, everybody? We're back. It's the Australian Sprint for our custom calendar. Geo's in 9th, Albon's in 12th. Got one extra lap of fuel in the car. Soft tires all the way, and let's see what we can do.
But just who comes out on top when the checkered flag flies? All the drivers on the grid about to take to Melbourne for the sprint. And it's lights out and away we go.
Nice little touch there that they actually programmed in the track name and then, or Crofty saying the track name and then the event, so he said Melbourne and Sprint, even though it's not actually part of the real calendar. But let's see what we can do here. We gotta save the tire. So we're gonna avoid high-risk curbs for a little bit, but we're gonna be in full attack.
Critical, we overtake.
Okay.
Come on.
Copy.
DRS enabled. P11. Magnus with you now. And Ocon behind.
I'm trying.
Let's crack on. Let's start to manage some PU temps.
Copy.
Thank you.
soon as I try to race anyone, I just have no chance.
All to play for. To use the overtake.
Yeah.
Now we've an incident here. Kevin Magnussen, it looks like. And if we watch Magnussen, within a split second, the impact's made.
There's a BSC. Close to the delta as you can.
Yep.
Focus and push.
Copy.
So we charge the pack.
Copy. Thank you.
PSC ending.
Okay.
Battery is good.
Confirm.
Okay, we are low in the pack. Coffee.
You can be aggressive with overtake usage.
Coffee. Thank you.
Right then, we can take a look now. Now here, we're taking turn 6.
Sorry, guys.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. This is really weird. It's a lot of front locking.
Well, that we didn't need happen, but at least he didn't destroy the car. And it looked like it
Max Verstappen
went through the barrier,
the finish line to win,
but we don't
the
have
sprint.
Any damage, so.
Okay, that's checkered flag 9.
Today's sprint has left Alex Albon without any points.
Look, today's strategy certainly didn't work for them, but they...
Well, there's nothing quite like it. Welcome along to race day.
Albert Park often seems to set teammate against teammate. From Hill and Villeneuve dueling for the 1996 win, to Bottas beating fellow Mercedes driver and pole sitter Hamilton to the win in 2019. And the weather is sunny here today, apart from a few clouds. Let's hope they remain scattered on the horizon.
In any case, Melbourne is ready and so are we. So strap yourself. Fans here in Melbourne are all set, as are the drivers, heading into 58 laps around Albert Park. And as the cameras turn to the Williams driver, you have to wonder what they can manage here.
They've done well to secure a P9 start, and they'll be keen to convert that into some points.
Get ready for the Australian Grand Prix. And it's lights out! And away we go!
It's critical we overtake.
Yep, copy.
still pretty slow through the corners. We gotta get that downforce increased.
Here we are then, looking at turn 12. The brakes couldn't cope, and they'll need to be mindful of the effect that that had on the tyres.
Okay, there's a big crash. Just remember, in the main straight, might still be some.
Now with the Haas. Dangerously close to each other. Oh, and the cars there, unable to keep out of each other's way. And there'll be more than one unhappy team after that.
Uh-oh, looked like it was on fire.
VSC. Keep Delta positive, stay up. Keep Delta positive.
Nope. It's good timing because we had just gotten out in front of Hamilton. That's a penalty for Magnussen.
VSC ending.
Yes, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, that's really unlucky.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
Why? What the?
Verstappen over the finish line and today's winner.
Get chicken flag. Get this P11.
Lando Norris, currently on our screens, heads back to his team.
Yep, definitely could have gone better, but we're lacking the downforce. Finally, factory fire is done. Got really unlucky with that. Hey, F1 Kev, what's going on? So, I think in here we're going to have to try to work on getting some downforce and keep our top speed. Nice, yeah. I'm gonna save the next race. I think I'm just gonna do the practice here, and then I'm gonna be on stream at Chef Negative's channel playing. I think we're doing Phasmophobia tonight, doing some ghost hunts on the new map that they added. Or should I say the overhauled map? So what's happening in our save? We just did the Australian sprint from our custom calendar. Didn't go really as planned. Valtteri Bottas rammed into the back of Albon, punted him off track, and that caused us basically to lose a points position on one of our cars. And Gio obviously doesn't have, since we have a factory fire that was happening. Sorry, we had a factory fire. It's over now. But before Australia, we had a factory fire, so we couldn't put all the new parts on the car 2. So, unfortunately, without the underfloor on car 2, Gio didn't get any points either. So, that was ultimately a disappointing race for our team, I think. Let's see how the board felt about it. Okay, so they weren't delighted, but they were happy. So, they weren't quite as satisfied as they were with the other races, because yeah, we didn't get any points, but just a lot of bad luck in that race. Really can't do much if someone else rams into you. So I'm just setting our goals for next race. So we can definitely have two cars in 15th. So we can say two cars, 13th or better for two races. We can definitely do that. We need the underfloor 2 on this second car, and then we need to also make the new suspension. If we put this new suspension on, we get a lot of low speed downforce, which we desperately need. So basically my goal here is to try to increase our downforce in all cornering areas while also keeping our top speed high. Your save, Stroll is first in the championship. Tsunoda 4th and Perez 8th. McLaren 3rd in the Constructors. Damn. Stroll in 1st place. Man, I think it's because somehow Aston Martin always does well. At least for this save that I'm in. They have, I think, the facility advantage when they start out in the save. So they're usually able to develop at a pretty quick pace, I think. Okay, so we've got some driver development updates. Albon has gotten better at defending. It's pretty good. I want him to have more cornering and braking, though. Gio's gained braking as well. Okay, so we need him to have cornering and braking. We need Gio to have the same thing. Yeah, a little bit more cornering and braking, and then we'll switch him over to driving standards. Well, actually, wheel to wheel. For Oliver, we'll keep his... We'll keep training him on accuracy, cornering, braking. And then after that, we'll switch him over to, I think, wheel to wheel or driving standards. Mercedes upgrade their wind tunnel. Alright, now we have to set the pit crew schedule here, so let's work on that. Alright, so this is one of those weekends where there's a lot of activity. This, we'll make this a rest day. We'll give him a half rest here. We can actually edit that and do more gym training. We need a car release training. 3 podiums in the first 5 races. Nice, well done. We're still waiting for our chance to get a podium here, but right now, yeah, the car is just... it's getting better. We have decent high speed downforce, but our low speed and medium speed downforce is still, you know, midfield territory here. Once we can escape the midfield and get our cornering downforce in the single digits, we should be able to fight for a podium, I think. And we're probably going to have to do this at the expense of some brake cooling and engine cooling, but I think it'll be worth it if we can just, you know, if we can get low speed and medium speed cornering into, like, you know, fifth or fourth. We don't necessarily have to be number one, but if we can just get up there, should be okay. Maybe we'll get a podium. We're good on the DRS and brake cooling. It's just, yeah, the car still needs work. Finally, we have the second underfloor for car two. Now we need the new suspension to give us more downforce. We could rush that and get two of them in 10 days. Let's rush and make sure we get it ahead of time. Team, I like to put more resources towards the design of the W24-3 underfloor. Complete it sooner. We'll need to pay some overtime. It's coming out of the cost cap. So they want $250,000 to make it faster by 5 days. Honestly, it doesn't really, for five days for $250,000, I don't think that's worth it, especially if it's not a race weekend. Yeah, I'm gonna just leave it alone. We're not gonna pay overtime. Okay, now we have a new front wing 3. We combine that with suspension 3. Okay, now this is more like it. Third and low speed cornering, 8th and medium, 3rd and high speed, 11th and top speed, and we still have 1st and DRS. We lost a lot of brake cooling though, but I think the downforce is definitely necessary here. You're safe. Mercedes are 4th and Ferrari are 6th. Wow. Ferrari in 6th? What happened? Okay, so regulations changes for 2025. Airflow focus changes, which basically, that's gonna affect all the DRS and downforce, I think, on a lot of these. go with cooling. Let's go with the cooling focus changes. At your Imola Grand Prix qualifying, you had a red flag. Damn, Porsche crashed. Paris P6 to Sonoda P9. I think we're, or at least the way the car is looking here, with our new parts, Imola should be a good one for us. Looks like we need chassis and underfloor because those are still on. Well, actually, those are in progress. And then we get ATR hours in 20 days. Is there anything we can complete in 20 days? I don't think so. I think what I'll do is, let's focus on finishing these other parts first. Okay, 18 days. Okay, we got even better on our car now, so second in low speed and high speed downforce. And we got a little bit more engine cooling back. We just need our top speed back too. Underfloor 3. Going to give us better medium and high speed downforce. Yo, Gio, what's up? If I could rush one of these underfloors. We'll have it for Suzuka. get ATR hours in 16 days. If we wait for the hours. I feel like doing another 0 hour right now. Is that gonna really do anything for us? Yeah, I think we just wait for the hours. We could do a 0 hour design, but I feel like we should try to save some money. Would like to get the design center upgraded so we can have more capacity. Refurbish our race simulator as well. We can't let this stay suboptimal for too long. Also want to get the final team hub for the staff development, but I'll wait for that one to get into the refurbish range before upgrading it again. Your Imola GP qualifying for his P11, Tsunoda P7. In your calendar, Imola is at ATA, right? An ATA weekend? We changed our calendar so that when we go to Imola, it's actually just a regular weekend. We actually have Suzuka as our ATA qualifying. And Suzuka's actually next race because we changed our calendar to match as close to the 2024 race order as possible. Wonder what the weather difference is, you know, in Japan at the beginning of the year versus the end of the year. It always seems to rain. It's chassis 2. Chassis for car 2. And, majority have voted in favor for the airflow focus changes. Damn it. Any gains that we make in DRS sensitivity or airflow sensitivity are going to be nerfed severely at 30%. That'll be fun to work around. ATR hours coming at 11 days. Kind of want to spread more ATR hours around in general instead of it doing min-max on one part. Because I think the way the current build looks pretty good. We just need to increase top speed. Like, we can take what we have here in the build and just kind of keep it the way it is without changing too much with the sliders, but just put more ATR hours in. We should benefit on the fourth iteration. Or sorry, every part right now we have is the third, so then we research. But when we do the design, we'll be doing the fourth iteration with hours, and then the fifth and final part will have the benefit of those ATR hours in it. MLGP. Sonoda P20. You can win off the track. Damn. Well, at least Paris is in the points. But yeah, if Sonoda fell all the way back there, that he went from points to nothing. Damn. Man, if it's not recoverable, if he can't recover, you might as well just retire the car. At that, you know, it's early in the race. And if he can't recover, though, might as well just save the engine wear. But, I don't know. Sometimes retiring is bad because the board doesn't like it when you retire a car. Nor does your driver. But it's strategically necessary. Like, because what happens is if your driver is in P20 and they're at very low confidence, and they try to fight, you know, they're trying to fight their way back up the order, and if they can't for some reason, they might actually cause another incident, and then it could be even worse. But I think Yuki has enough skill where he might be able to, get back up through the back markers in midfield. I guess it really depends on how good your car is, too. Got heavy rain in practice. Qualifying is going to be clear, and then the race is going to have moderate rain. Track. I don't think they're going to actually be able to do 30 laps. before the rain starts. I guess that's my prediction. With 25 laps on each car. Setups. So at Japan they like 8.5, 12.5, 3.7, 3.50, and 0. Car 2. Sorry, this should be 8.5, 12.5, 3.7, 3.50, and 0. And then this one, car 2, should be 7.0, 13.0, 5.5, 3.45, and then 0. Taking a look at the water line. Okay, it looks like we're gonna have a large downpour of water towards the middle of practice.
Ready to check, Alex?
Yes, copy.
Yeah, all good.
So I think we keep the cars out for a little bit.
What are we thinking about tires here?
And then we go right to the wet tire.
Further rain expected.
Copy.
So it's raining, just watch shot.
Copy.
Track, please.
Okay, bring the cars in now. And then now we go to the wet tire. If this were real life, there would be so much water spray.
Really happy with it.
Yeah, it could be.
Back on the car.
weather update, level zero rain around the track.
Yes.
Almost ready for dry tires again. It's cooling both cars. With the hard tire. If it was real life, it'd be a red flag with that much water. Yeah, I think so. It was like 6 millimeters of water, or over 6. That's pretty much what happened last year, if you remember. Right? It was so much rain, they had to stop the race, or the session. And they waited it out. Then at some point it resumed. Actually, kind of remember that because I think I, when last year. When it was Suzuka, I did a live stream, like with a watch along with the F1 timings on the screen. And we're just chatting. Obviously, I can't restream the F1 broadcast, but I had the live timings on the screen. We're just talking to people in chat. Also had the telemetry data of Lando Norris, comparing him to I think we were comparing Norris and, was it Albon? I don't remember. Not Albon, but I know we were definitely looking at Lando's top speed. Had his telemetry on there with the timings. Might do another one of those. Maybe for Las Vegas. I'll do a Las Vegas GP watch along with the live timings on screen. I don't know how many people will hang around and watch it, but it could be an option. Keep it at 30 laps, fuel.
That's great.
There's a yellow flag now.
Las Vegas is 6 a.m. your time? Wow. I'm really curious because a lot of people are saying the weather in Las Vegas
more rain to come
at that time of year is very cold, or not cold, but you know, it's chilly, and the track will not be, they're saying the track temps are going to be too cold. There's going to be no grip on the tires, at least according to people who live in Las Vegas, I guess.
Coming.
Coming.
Looks like this chart looks like intermediates. It might go over 4 millimeters at this point, but looks like it drops down very sharply. Put intermediate tire. Immediate, send it. Well, GP race results, Perez P9, Tsunoda P6. Nice. Damn, from P20 to P6. That's a hell of a comeback. Good thing he didn't have damage, I guess, because if he had damage, probably wouldn't have been able to do that. Australia race, that's pretty much Albon getting rear-ended and then punted off track for P17, then he came back to P12. But I think with all the new parts that we have on the car, we should be pretty good here.
There's a lot of relocking.
Just look at how wet the asphalt is. Struggling with the car, but that's just the risk you take. Oof. The later you leave it.
That wasn't too bad, honestly. It just kind of cut some of the grass there.
No further rain expected.
Copy.
Session's pretty much over anyway. Yes, that's right. Magnussen has a penalty because he crashed into one of the, I think it was an AlphaTauri. Right, was it? Last race, and then that took him out. So he couldn't serve his 5-second penalty, so the penalty carries over. So it's actually not going to rain this session. Sorry, today is the dry day, and then... yeah, qualifying is sunny, but the race is going to be moderate or light rain. Albon almost at 100%. Let's call in the car early. We'll let Gio just finish this stint and then move on to qualifying. Okay, we'll just leave them in the garage for now and save the engine wear.
Will practice pay off for the drivers? Well, we're about to find out in qualifying.
In our custom ATA qualifying at Suzuka, so let's see what we can do here. I'm going to keep the 53% engine on for now, along with the 46% gearbox. And let's just see how fast we can go. Since this is an ATA qualifying, we only have one hard tire, so we kind of have to just only do two runs. I think if you do three runs on the hard tire, it might wear it down too much.
That's a red.
please.
Here we are then, reaching turn 13.
No.
Oh, that'll be a costly crash as the car makes contact with the wall.
Oh,
I imagine
no.
Their confidence will have taken a knock.
I think I see a fire.
And you can just feel the...
No, Gio, what'd you do? That is not what I wanted to happen. Damn it. Wonder how bad the car got messed up. Engine, gearbox, and ERS? Oh god.
Currently P1.
Okay, so go in lap. Go switch in lap.
Okay. I think he destroyed the whole car. I don't think we have any money to replace anything right now. If I were playing this offline, I would definitely reload the game at this point, but I made a promise that I would not save scum. Oh god, look at this. Chassis, front wing, rear wing, suspension, engine, ERS, and the gearbox. Everything's destroyed, except for the side pods and underfloor. Oh my god. what did you do? And it's parked firmly, so I can't, We don't have any money to do this right now. What the hell? Literally can't continue without going into debt. And since it's park firmly, I can't make any changes. This is kind of a bug, I don't know. What the hell's going on? Damn, I really have to... I don't know what's going on. This, don't have enough parts, so it won't let me proceed without going into debt. I have to literally emergency manufacture. And that, actually, I wouldn't even be able to put this on. I'd have to do this one. This is bullshit. Why won't you let me put the old chassis on? I'm gonna have to do this to proceed. Might as well buy a new ERS, just because he's already P20.
So close to zero, but negative.
And then we're boxing.
Yeah.
I don't know, that was kind of bullshit.
Currently P3.
That was a really good lap, mate. Well done.
So, boxing this lap then.
Copy.
Look at Albon, P3.
So keep the delta negative where you can.
Slow on the inlap.
Copy.
Okay, that's the flag.
The excitement is building, there's electricity in the air. But there's no surprise in that, it's race day.
We're gonna need all this money. I don't know, I think I might actually just reload it. But I think that's gonna be it for now. I will be on Shep Negative stream in about 1 hour. Let's see, is there anybody to raid? Yeah, I don't see anybody that I want to raid right now. But I'll be back on Chef Negative stream. And I'll be playing Phasmophobia with him. If you want to give him a follow, there's his channel. And I'll be on that one later. Thanks for watching, thanks for following, thanks for chatting, everybody. And VOD watchers, if you're out there, appreciate you as well. See you next time.